This is it, sir. I suspect Havelock Martin and Lord Pendleton landed there a while ago and went into the lighthouse. Knowing them, they're not giving up without a fight. I remember hearing the Admiral and Martin talking about this place as where they'd hold up if they had to. Anybody going in has to breach the fort, the gatehouse, and there's only one way to the top. All I can say is that it's been a pleasure serving with you. Maybe after all this is settled, we'll see each other again. Good luck, Corvo. If anyone deserves it, you do. Give my best to Emily. After she's on the throne, she won't have time for an old man like me. I knew you were sharp, Corvo. But somehow you managed to get through all this mess without losing sight of what really matters. For that, I respect you. The city's gonna pull itself up, I believe. Too many good people here to let it all turn to ashes. I'd best be going. The battlefield's no place for an old sailor like me. That time is long past. Good luck, my friend.
Cigars tonight?
Indeed, I believe so.
Mm-hmm.
anybody with signs of this?
Who turned off the wall of lights by the dock? Is that a good idea?
Couldn't tell you. The whole place is turning into a madhouse, if you ask me.
Where'd he go?
When I...
Here you are! Take it!
Remember when this was just a dream you shared with you, angry, desperate man in the back room of a bar? Lord Trevor Pendleton, the neglected youngest son, bullied by your brothers. Martin. Such a clever man. His talents wasted until he found his fate. Callista, the nursemaid. Bitter Piero, ejected from the academy. Samuel, a useless old man, hungry for purpose. Couldn't be with us tonight. Me, unjustly dismissed from the Navy over an affair of honor. My friends, the times we've had. I'm almost sorry this moment has come. Our enemies have fallen. We've put an empress on the throne who will take years to grow up. And by the time she does, she'll be ours. She's young. Emily the First could reign for 60, 70 years if she's kept safe. Oh, what we could do in that time. Look how much we've changed the city already. The golden age is coming. And no one will ever know what I had to do for it. You won't tell, will you? This is all Martin's fault. If we hadn't helped Corvo get out of prison, if Corvo hadn't been so damn good at his job, if we hadn't gotten greedy, afraid. If. Always too sure that was my problem. Never hesitated. Too sure of what I wanted. Too sure of what I wanted to do when other men stopped to consider. Saw it as a weakness. I know Corvo's coming for me just like he came for the others. Crossing the island below like it was nothing. Only a question of how and when. But I'm lacking a countermove. It's all fallen apart. All the steps that led us here made sense. When I was young, I went to sea. Took command of a ship and made aimless men into sailors. Made a collection of boats into a navy. Then founded a conspiracy and almost led an empire. No compromise. Never showed mercy. Never showed weakness. I showed the world what mattered. Will and vision. And not being afraid of getting dirty. And now, I'll lose it all to a man with a faster sword hand. Or is it that he has a slower sword hand? There's something wrong with the world. It'll make a good story for the history. I'll have a good epitaph. In his time, he commanded a noble lord, a high overseer, and an empress. The man who brought down a tyrant. Admiral Havelock, son of the high ocean. Did you think I'd fight you, Corvo? Sorry to disappoint. This is yours. The key to Emily's cell. She'll be glad to see you. You made quite an impression on her. Did you know that? She asked about you constantly. Where you were. What you'd been doing. I told her. In the end, I told her everything. From the start, when we had such noble goals in mind. To the end, when we were afraid, fighting in secrecy about who we could trust and who we had to kill. Arguing over who would act as new Lord Regent. And she listened, eyes wide. She's become an interesting girl. If she lives, she'll make a memorable empress. Go ahead. Kill me or take me to Coldridge Prison. Make your choice. She'll be watching.
Guards! Shooting! Sir, are you? Is it going to be okay now? Will I be Empress?
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is, with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. And decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.
Long enough for all of the big and the small, where the taller they stand, where the harder they fall. We live for today, but we die for the next. With blood in our veins, in the air, in our chest, or we step into war with our hearts on the line. The dirt on our boots, it shakes free over time. It's a distant aroma at best, a withering smile that's stuck deep in your vest. The night air, it wraps its fingers around your body, it shakes from a now distant sound. Oh, the sound of her voice, a sweet symphony, played over and over until you are free.
Yeah. Thank you.